All family trees start somewhere. The people's Kenpo family tree finds its roots in India over 1,000 years ago. A young monk who came from royalty named Bodhidharma. Bodhidharma lived a peaceful life of reflection and contemplation until one day his monastery was attacked. The young monk watched helplessly as his fellow monks were killed savagely. The monks had had no idea how to defend themselves against such violence. So young Bodhidharma went off to meditate. He meditated for 9 long years until he came up with a solution. The first movements of Kenpo. Kenpo's modern history starts a little closer to home. 100 years ago, a young man named James Matosi was told by his father he had to leave his beautiful home of Hawaii and travel to Japan to learn religion and the martial arts. It was difficult for young James in Japan, but when he returned home to Hawaii, he was very, very good and began to take on students of his own. One young man had already trained with his father, a Buddhist priest. His name was William Chow. Chow felt his father's methods were not street applicable, and when he teamed with Matosi, the system they designed was 100% dangerous, and they called the system Kenpo Jiu-Jitsu. Around this same time, another young man, whose father was a boxer, began training at the official self-defense club with William Chow. The young man was a Filipino, very good with sticks, whose name was Adriano Imperado. Imperado spent many years with Chow, becoming his chief instructor, and it was Imperado who changed the system once again to Kaju Kenpo, the legendary and brutal fighting system, combining karate, judo, jiu-jitsu, Kenpo, and boxing. Imperado was quoted as saying, "The workout wasn't over unless there was blood on the dojo floor." The young flyweight boxing champion Mariano Tiwanak was so impressed with the fighting system after being beaten up by Adriano Imperado, he decided to join Kaju Kenpo. And this is where our story catches up.
My dad is Shotokan. He did Shotokan karate and he did Kodokan judo. Okay. So I trained from 8 years old and my friends are playing. So I kept telling my dad, why should I train? Why do I have to train? Well, he said, you have to because someday you understand.
Sensei Bill wanted to understand what his father was talking about, but he also wanted to learn on his own terms.
This is where Hawaiian Kenpo came in. From there, I went into, I met a man, a boxer, he was a professional boxer, and he was Mariano Tiwanak. All right, so then I started working with Mariano, and then I met Imperado.
Sensei Bill trained with these men, but not with dreams of becoming a dojo owner, but of becoming a veterinarian. After leaving university, Sensei Bill flew to California to pursue his dreams. But it was the movies, not animals, that came calling. Sensei Bill was working as a Hollywood stuntman, but other dreams were starting to call him. Sensei Bill helped many of his friends who had martial arts schools, and because they could sense his love of family, the smaller students were immediately drawn to him.
So I end up with the school because they're going to leave, and then I end up with the kids because I love kids. So I used to, I teach the kids. So it goes back to what my dad said. My dad said, you know what? Someday you understand. Someday you understand. And the whole time I've been doing it, I've been wondering, what does that mean? So, but now I know. I got to see so.
But that is another story.